What's going on, you guys? It's your boy Ultra Rim here, back in the building with another sick and lit edition of Wrestleshade. And I just wanted to make this video tonight because I did not do the regular, you know, Wrestleshade react. I am in the middle of like unpacking and cleaning and this and this and that, and bitch, I'm running around like a chicken with my head cut off. But I did see Raw tonight, so just want to go over some highlights, you know what I'm saying, just a small recap of this week's episode of Monday Night Raw. First and foremost, shouts out to Vince McMahon and or creative, whoever made the decision to put NXT talent in the audience, in the seats, so to speak, so that, you know, they could give off a audience effect. That was hot. Did y'all take tea from Tony Khan over at AEW? I don't know. All I know, bitch, they was caged up like birds, bitch. Okay. Plexiglass everywhere, bitch. It was hot, though. But, I mean, I don't know. Like, it makes me, like, feel like, okay, bitch, is this the future? Bitch, if we go back to a WWE show, bitch, we can be caged up like that, bitch. I bet you. We started the show off with Kevin Owens and the Kevin Owens Show. Mind y'all, he tried to do that last week. Did not happen, bitch. And so we started off the Kevin Owens Show with Asuka. Then we had Charlotte come out. Then we had Natalya come out. Then we had Nia Jax come out. So after that, it just became a shade fest. You know what I'm saying? Nia Jax was assuring to everybody that she was going to win. She was going to brutalize everybody. Blah, 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 blah. Interesting. We had a match between Andrade and Apollo Crews. Is the new United States champ, bitch. Y'all thought he was gonna crash and burn out there, bitch. Come on, bitch.
In this ring, and say to the whole world, that I'm the new United States champion. Woo, that feels so good to say.
Come on, Apollo, bitch. And here go Andrade going backstage, going crazy.
Seth Rollins and this Rey Mysterio thing. Pastor Rollins, bitch. I mean, I'm just, like, really shocked that he didn't pass around the collection plate tonight. He had Rey Mysterio's mask in hand, literally still toying with Rey Mysterio. And he introduces us to his new church member, his new disciple, Austin Theory. Then you have a little speech that Buddy Murphy gives, you know, telling the world that, you know, he needed a leader and he found Seth Rollins. And then you have Austin Theory coming up telling the world that, you know, he had no friends. He felt like people abandoned him and he found Seth, and Seth is making them just better people, bitch. Okay. Next, we cut to what we thought was going to be a promo with Charlie and Charlotte, but Asuka chimed in, okay, as Charlotte was professing to be the most the most prolific women's wrestler of all time, bitch. Asuka chimes in, hashtag red is not your color. Oh, bitch, I was dead, bitch. Oh my god, Asuka giving you Japanese shade, bitch, all across the board, bitch. This was hot. Like I said earlier, I really love how WWE is letting Asuka really like express herself and kind of have more of a leeway with her character. Here we go again, bitch, with the Iconics. We got Peyton apologizing to Billy Kay. Billy Kay apologizing to Peyton. We got the girls taking a trip down memory lane. Alexa Bliss and Nikki Cross come out. And as soon as, you know, the tag team champs get ready to talk, the women's tag team champs, excuse me, get ready to talk, and Nikki Cross is about to say something, Billy Kay cuts her off, telling Nikki Cross that she doesn't need to speak, okay, that she needs to be grateful and just stand there. Oh, God, bitch. And when I tell you Nikki snapped, okay, Nikki Cross snapped on the Iconics, bitch, telling them they don't know what she had to do to get to her spot, telling them she scratched and clawed, you know, explaining her and Alexa Bliss's friendship, you know, letting them know that she had no friends, bitch, you know what I'm saying? She couldn't trust nobody, blah, 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 blah. And she just snapped. It was a really, really good job. Hashtag Nikki Cross. Nikki Cross definitely shined tonight. When I tell you, you guys, I was trying to run to the bathroom on this next part and I couldn't catch everything all the way, but I know I heard Lana's voice, and Lana was like, I need to talk to you or we need to discuss something. And she got straight up dissed. Oh, God. I don't know if it was by MVP or Bobby Lashley. I feel like it was by MVP, but Lana was like, we need to talk. And the reply was, no, we don't. You're talking about destroyed, bitch. Oh, my God. It was funny. But anyway, we move along to Club MVP. Hashtag Claymore to MVP, bitch. That's absolutely no shade, bitch. I thought that Claymore took MVP out of his clothes, bitch. Like, I thought his blazer was flying in the wind, bitch. He got Claymored. And that was a great sale. He was selling that Claymore really, really well. We have Natalya next. In an interview where she thought she was about to be in an interview, but she got a collect call from a local prison. No, let me stop. But she got a call from TJ. We all know about TJ, bitch. If you watch Total Divas, bitch, you all know about her husband, TJ. So we're not even going to go there. But they get on the phone. They argue with each other. And Natalya turns back around to try to do the interview, bitch. And the time was up. And I'm just thinking to myself, okay, like, this little promo, bitch, this little interview is only going to be about 5-10 minutes, bitch. I'm going to go ahead and let this phone just ring or put it on silent, and he'll just catch this voicemail, okay? And if it's important, bitch, he'll blow my phone up or text me. I'm going to go ahead and do this interview and cut this promo. Like, next, we had Kevin Owens versus Angel Garza, which was a pretty cool match. Kevin Owens was already walking the dogs on Garza, I thought, you know, especially when he did that DDT and that senton. But Kevin Owens has suffered some injury to his knee. And it was a great match. But, you know, Garza also, too, took Kevin Owens out with the wing clipper chicken wing dinner. And so, yeah, that was the end of Kevin Owens. But it was, all in all, it was great. Kevin Owens actually shined tonight, too, you know. He was in about 5 different segments, bitch, so. We had a phenomenal 3-way dance between Nia Jax, Charlotte, and Natalya. This was a really, really good match. I'll be uploading my reaction to that match. All I gotta say for now is hashtag sharpshooter, hashtag figure eight, and hashtag Samoan drop, bitch. Y'all three ladies killed it. And Asuka did too on the sideline. No shade, we ain't gonna leave her out the group, bitch. They do gotta fight her. So, oh yes, and yes too, Nia Jax became victorious. Nia Jax was victorious in this matchup. Kind of felt like she was gonna win, but you know, it could have easily went to Charlotte. We all know it won't gonna go to Natty, even though it kind of like needs to. But anyway, it was a great match. I have no idea, bitch. We had a chance to hear from Gronkowski. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. We had a chance to hear from Gronk and R-Truth. R-Truth pretty much telling Gronk that he's going to get his baby back. And Gronk pretty much telling us he got eyes in the back of his head. Oh, God, that promo made my ass hurt. Ric Flair. Cuts a, you know, Ric Flair just, you know, bitch. Ric Flair cuts the absolute best promos, bitch. Okay, I just want to go drink a whole bottle of Ritalin, bitch, after I listen to a Ric Flair promo, bitch. Anyway. Ric Flair is showing massive, massive support for Randy Orton in this greatest match ever between him and Edge, which, I mean, you guys kind of already felt like he was going to do that. I mean, it's no shade, bitch. I kind of want Randy to win too, but that's neither here nor there, bitch. I'm not even going to talk about it. I'm absolutely not even going to talk about it. But you guys, Ric Flair, no longer wheeling and dealing, no longer jet flying, limousine riding, nursing home stunting, son of a gun. He's retiring his player's card, I guess. He said it in the promo. He said he was no longer doing it, okay? Oh, God, and speaking of promos. Liv Morgan, baby, we love you. Just want to let you know that we love you, okay, with all that you're going through, bitch. But look, week after week, Liv Morgan is cutting these promos, talking about, I know who I am, okay? I'm living, I'm alive, I'm Liv Morgan, and when I find out what I need to find out, I'm gonna find out, but I know that I'm living, and life is living. It's just like, Liv Morgan, come on, girlfriend, bitch, we love you, bitch, like, come on, you just gotta, I have no idea, I don't know what to say. I really think like creative is giving her a chance to like really like freestyle and wing it and like really turn this into something big. And I just don't know. But when she find out, we'll know. That's all I can say. And last, you guys, we have this tag team match between the Street Profits and Team Lash VP. That's right, Bobby Lashley and MVP were on teams tonight versus Montez Ford and Angelo Dawkins. Hope I pronounced that right as well. Montez Ford showing off in the beginning of the match. MVP still professing to call them clowns. I mean, he was really dogging them out. But to be honestly truthful with y'all, bitch, all I remember was Drew McIntyre music dropping, Drew getting in the ring, bitch, and him and Bobby Lashley was going in, okay? At first, ain't gonna lie, they was playing patty cake at first. But as they got outside of the ring and started pushing each other into the barricade and into that plexiglass, bitch, I was like, okay, this is what I need to see. This is what I want. It's about time. This is really, really good, you guys. They had the trainees. I guess they had the NXT trainees come out and try to break them up at the end of the match. It didn't happen. The first round of trainees, the first wave of trainees got wiped out. All of them received claymores to the middle of the skull, okay? And the second round of trainees all got thrown out of the ring. So they had some of the helpers come up and dagnabbit those damn helpers. That just them helping, that little extra bit of strength, just them coming up, was they were able to keep Bobby Lashley and Drew McIntyre from killing each other tonight on Monday Night Raw. So, I thought it was pretty cool. I thought Monday Night Raw was hot tonight. If I had to rate Monday Night Raw from a 1 to a 10, 1 being the worst and 10 being the greatest, I would probably give Monday Night Raw a 7 tonight. A 7.5 maybe. I thought it was a really good show. So, you guys, leave your comments, thoughts, and suggestions in the comment section below. Hope everybody is staying safe. Hope everybody is staying healthy and taking care of themselves. I am out. Love you guys. Peace.